Hello there, and welcome back to another draft video here on Channel Fireball. I'm Marshall. Yeah, that one from Limited Resources, and we're jumping into this is a Kamigawa Neon Dynasty draft. It's pretty new at the time of recording. This is fairly early in the format for me. And it looks like we've got a nice one here with Tatsunari Toad Rider. If you can pair that up with any enchantment, it spits out 3/3, so that's pretty nice. Kamano Faces Kakazan has been really powerful in the aggressive decks. Invigorating Hot Springs, just kind of a nice way to keep on tossing counters around. What does this do again? Not a huge fan of that one. This guy's okay. Twisted Embrace you can play. Good removal spell. Greater Tanuki can open up the door for a lot of mana splash and ramp stuff. I think I'm just going to go with the Toad Rider here, though. We'll give him a shot. And what do we pick up next? No, that's nothing. Is there any good black cards? Death to the Kami or Enormous Energy Blade? No. Repel the Vile, Suit Up. It's weird. The other pack was actually very strong, and this one's much weaker by comparison. I think I'm just going to take Enthusiastic Mechanaut. Yeah, they don't really go together at all, but this way I have the highest upside possibility from each of these two cards. So I probably, the chance that I play both of them is very low. But whichever direction I end up going, I'm going to have a very solid card out of it rather than having like a pretty good card and a mediocre card. Okay. Ooh, Containment Construct. That goes with the Enthusiastic Mechanaut and just kind of the general artifact build. This thing's cool if you can get it going. There's a few different ways that you can get discard going kind of repeatedly, but, you know, generally speaking, you know, you can look to cards with channel, you know, as a way to do it. All right, what do we got? Assassin's Ink. Destroy target creature, Planeswalker for 4 mana or less. That's quite strong. Rabbit Batteries, also a good card. And it goes with the Mechanaut. But I could have Assassin's Ink, Toad Rider, and Containment Construct. And I think it's close. You know, the Construct can go with the Mechanaut okay, but you can also just play it in whatever. Yeah, I'll go for the Assassin's Ink here. A lot of time these decks end up being Grixis anyway, and then, yeah, we could just throw the Toad Rider in if we have just, like, really anything else. This card's pretty good for that deck as well. Whenever one or more artifacts you control leave the battlefield during your turn, you get a 1/1 Construct, and then you can tap, sack an artifact to drain them for one. We'll go for it. Grixis Artifacts with just some good value spells here. I could live with that. Okay, maybe I just go with Mnemonic Sphere here. I still am not really interested in the Enormous Energy Blade. Inkrai's Infiltrator, not really this either. So I'll go for the Sphere. It does have kind of a cool combo with the Containment Construct, so maybe we can make it work. All right, maybe I should take this too. I don't know. I could take Moonsnare Prototype, which has been fine. Chain Flail Centipede is interesting too. It is an artifact. Yeah, I'll just go with that. I think the Reality Heist is fine, but not really exciting. Papercraft Decoy, nah, I'll take this. So we're like black artifacts right now, roughly speaking. This is our wheel pack. And we got back Okiba Salvage. Kind of interesting. I think I'm just going to take Bloodfell Caves, though, just to try to make sure our mana is okay. All right, this pack just kind of stinks. I still don't want Enormous Energy Blade. That card's just not good. Just Kaka Suit Up, I guess. Futurist Sentinel, really bad. Yeah, everything here is just bad. That's fine, though. This is the last few picks of the pack. We don't expect it to be anything particularly great. So how does this deck look? Yeah. Take another Centipede. It's getting there, I guess. I mean, our power level's okay. We just need to keep on hammering the artifact stuff, I think, and then I think that deck will be okay. Okay, let's see what we got here. Thousand Face Shadow. Which one is this? Oh, the clone one. Yeah, that's okay. What else we got? Another Bloodfell Caves or an Uncharted Haven. Hopefully we get one of those back. We'd play either. This is pretty good. The Sky Swarmer Koi. How are we doing on fours? We have a couple of them right now. Just haven't been that impressed by this card. It's fine. Like, you can play it on one, ninjutsu something else, and then ninjutsu this at a later time, but it just hasn't been really that great. I kind of like this card, or maybe the Sky Swimmer Koi here. And then I'm hoping to wheel one of these lands. Long Reach of Night's okay. It's grindy. I'll take it. See how it does. Ooh, there's another one. That could get kind of interesting. There's also another Mechanaut. What else? Sling, Song Shaper, sure. An Uncharted Haven, which we could probably use. I would play a Tamiyo's Completion, but it's not really a priority. I think it's between these two. And I think I'm just going to go with another Mechanaut here. I want to see some more colorless stuff so I can start taking advantage of the reduction, though. All right, Moonsnare Specialist. Just a great card. I will take it. Nozomi Prowler. Oh, that's not the one I was hoping it was. Twisted Embrace could make the cut. Is there any good artifacts here? Playable, but nothing great. This thing is an artifact, but whatever. I'm just going to take Twisted Embrace. That kind of already starts to put us into like decent removal territory here with the specialist, you know, interacting and then the two hard removal spells. We're already starting to look okay. Ooh, Dragonspark Reactor. Yes, please. Unfortunately, there's a Dismal Backwater that we probably won't wheel. There will be three cards in the pack. What will those cards be? They will be Kindled Fury, Dragonfly Suit, and maybe one of these two. And I'm going to say Bear of Memory. That's my prediction. In the meantime, though, we're going to take the Dragonspark Reactor because it's actually pretty strong in these decks. Unfortunately, nothing for us here. The only cards on color are these ones down here, and they don't really do anything. I'll just grab an uncommon. Oh, another Dragonspark Reactor? Okay. Boy, I wish we could get this Ironhoof Boar back, but I don't think we're going to. This is seventh pick. So the wheel, we're hoping to get one of those dual lands, either the Choose Your Duel or the another Bloodfell Caves. Either one would be fine. We're clearly heavy black with lesser blue and red, so that makes our mana a little bit easier to manage, but that's where that fixing can really come in handy. Okay, this is an important piece as well as the experimental synthesizer. I probably would actually run one of these expensive artifact payoffs as well, but in the meantime, I really want to get cards like synthesizer going. You know, these are really important because they let you keep going through your deck and they trigger things like the Dragonspark Reactor and the Oni Cult Anvil and stuff like that. All right, so we didn't wheel either land. We did get the Sky Swarmer Koi back, so we can be happy about that, but yeah, that's not great for us. Should I take the Searchlight Companion over the Koi? It is an artifact. I think I'm going to, actually. We have a ton of fours as well. All right, the completion came back, but so did the Song Shaper, and I'm just going to take that here. I just need artifacts, and creatures that are artifacts are even better. All right, what does this puppet do again? Enters battlefield for each kind of counter. Yeah, I don't think even if it is an artifact, I don't think I can do it. Okay, nothing. And then this card's, I think, just unplayable. All right, let's see what three cards are left in this pack. See if we were right. Kindled Fury. Oh, the Dragonfly suit. This is the only one that we were wrong about. We got those two, though. Sure. I don't think we're going to play Kindled Fury, so I'm just going to put it in the board. All right. Ooh, Replication Specialist. Boom. Ship that nonsense right over here. Fantastic. So this thing lets you pay one and a blue extra for any artifact, non-token artifact that ETBs on your side. And you get to copy it. Just straight up, you just get a copy of it. You put this thing down, next turn you're like, Tawashi Song Shaper, pay four mana, you get two of them. Oh man, and Scrap Welder. Sweet. And then maybe we will one of these two artifact creatures. I don't think I care about the hover bike particularly, but yeah, I'm going to take Scrap Welder here. This is fine. It isn't like a bomb in this deck, but it, you know, this is where you want it generally. We just need as many artifacts as we can possibly get at this point. That's the main thing. Like every pick we make hopefully is an artifact from here on out. We've got a decent amount, but like our upper stuff is a lot of like this and this, you know, stuff that aren't artifacts, and we need them to be. We got to have critical mass. Especially after having picked up the Dragonspark reactors and then the anvil. Okay, Unstoppable Ogre. Yeah, I don't like the cudgels very much, and we need to, again, prioritize artifacts. And honestly, artifact creatures are probably the best thing we can do, because if we play a whole bunch of artifacts like these that don't actually do anything to the board, we can still just get kind of ran over. Where if we play like an Unstoppable Ogre, let's say it doesn't even open it up an attack, we're just like, this thing, go. Like, it blocks well. They have to get it out of the way, or they have to trade something for it. And then next thing you know, the anvil's triggering. We got triggers off of the reactor, and we're kind of off to the races. All right, what do we have here? Moonsnare Prototype, or I could take a Scrapyard Steelbreaker. And I'm pretty good on fours here. I think I want the Prototype, actually. I don't love it. I also could take Iron Apprentice here, which tends to leave the battlefield and is trivially easy to get onto the battlefield. You know, I'm going to do that. I also like just cheap cards in the format. I guess I like that in every format, but definitely in this one. So yeah, we'll give old, look at him carrying that wrench or whatever it is. I'm in. Oof. Oh boy, this is a tough one. Man. So Bronze Plate Boar or even Undercity Scrounger, both really good. But there's also Voltage Surge, which is a good removal spell that also goes well in this deck. But man, I just don't know if I want to spend another pick on a not artifact here. There's also the chance that we wheel this, this, or maybe this. Yeah, I'm just going to take the Scrounger. It's in our primary color and it's pretty strong. Ooh, combo? This is leaves the battlefield, right? Yeah. Reinforce Ronin into the Oni Cult Anvil. That's pretty sweet. Trashbot could actually be playable in this deck, maybe, but I like the Ronin. Oh, another Anvil. Kami of Industry would make the cut in this deck too, but I'm just going to go all in. Two Anvils. Three Reactors. Oh, man. I'm cutting like so much not. It's going to be really tough to make the deck if you're not an artifact or cares about artifact card. Like, I may cut some of this removal. I'm going to cut Long Reach of Night. Okay, another Unstoppable Ogre. Ooh, a Virus Beetle. That's perfect. Because that tends to leave the battlefield a lot for the anvils. Like, it just dies. I mean, look at our setup. I may need to cut a moon snare specialist. It makes me shiver just to think of it, but I might do it. All right, sling or another scrounger? We have room for a three if I want it. Sling dies more, but is better in aggro, generally speaking. Still, it is cheap, and I'll take it here. Whatever, none of these are going to make the cut. Steelbreaker could. I'll put it in the main for now, but I think I may end up cutting it. I'm kind of looking to cut a couple of these centipedes if I can get away with it. I think I would just want to be a more defensive stance for this deck if possible. And this is ultimately a 2-2 for 3 that sometimes does some things. But it is an artifact creature, which matters, so we'll see how our account is for that. But if I was going to cut one, that would be a good place to look, I think. Do I have any artifacts of note here? These two things and that, so no. All right, so let's see what we got. Artifact. So those are all in. I got to cut 5 cards. Sphere, I think I like. All of this stuff's in. That's in. Yeah, so these are on the chopping block. The Toad Rider's definitely on the chopping block. It feels weird because it is a pretty sweet card, but in fact, it's just gone. I think I'm going to cut the Moonsnare Specialist. Also, because if I can get my splash down a little, that helps. I mean, these are a little bit awkward. This thing's just great. Ambusher's mediocre, but probably still worth putting in. Yeah, like I could see cutting these three. Maybe I'm supposed to cut one of these removal spells. How important is the Welder? Sacrifice an artifact with mana value X, and then you get a smaller one. So basically, I can sack a 2 for a 3, excuse me, a 2 for a 1 or a 3 for a 2, and then maybe if I include this and or this, I could get back one of these mediocre cards. So not really great. But what about the 3s for the 2s? I have 3 different artifacts, and I can get back Construct, an Anvil, a Mechanaut, the Reactor again, a Beetle, a Sphere, or I can actually, wait a minute, are these all, so these are all artifacts? Oh, wow. So every card I have that costs 1 or 2 mana is an artifact. So if I get Scrap Welder down and get anything in the graveyard that costs 1 mana, then any artifact that costs 2 or more can get it back. And if I have any 1 or 2 mana artifact, then I can get it back. From a 3 or a 4. Okay, so let's get these out of here. I think the Welder's worth holding on to. The other option I have here is to hang on to this or one of the, what's it called, the centipedes, and then cut a land. Our curve actually isn't that high. We curve at 5. It's more just like availability of mana, you know, of colors. But I think I can get away with, oh, what did I just do? Oh, cutting one land, right. Like, oh, maybe like that. I don't think I can quite get away with that. Yeah, the mana just looks too bad with these double spells, double mana symbols here. So I don't think I'm going to do that. I think I will just cut the, the centipede, not the scrounger. I want him. Okay. I could also cut this. The sphere is very mediocre and not really worth splashing for. I don't know. Do I want a chain flail centipede instead of it? Maybe. How many creatures is this? 14? Yeah, I'm right kind of where I want to be. I guess I'll try it. Then I'm splashing for this and then these two powerful options. All right, so there's our deck. Let's take it for a spin and see what it does. As we head into round number 1, I want to remind you this video is brought to you by Channel Fireball. Make sure you check them out for all of your Kamigawa Neon Dynasty needs. And if you do end up picking up something over there, if you use the affiliate code LR at checkout, it lets them know that I sent you over. And I do appreciate it. Let's see how our mana goes. I think our mana is going to be the crux here. If we hit our mana, okay, I think we're in business. Like, this looks good. And then if we don't, I think we're going to, you know, we're going to struggle a bit. All right. So this thing reconfigures to give +2/+0 whenever it attacks. Okay. And then this thing is a 3/2 lifelink with ninjutsu for 1 and a black. Ooh, nice. Yeah, so let's just get the reactor going here. Play it first and then follow it up with all artifacts. Usually a good way to go. Okay, I will play this. Probably just trade this off. Because if I can get this thing going, then I'm probably in pretty good shape. And if they're going to be red, white aggro, I think just getting a creature off the board is probably worth the trade. Yeah, and this kind of signals to me that it would have been worth the trade, the fact that my opponent is sort of protecting this at all costs, you know. All right, I'm going to go with Synthesizer. I was just going to play this, but I can go Synthesizer, see what we hit. Ooh, we hit an anvil. Screw it. I'll play that. My opponent hasn't put that much pressure on us. Okay, and then whenever one or more artifacts you control leave the battlefield during your turn, create a 1/1 construct token. This ability triggers only once. So I can sacrifice the Synthesizer here to make a 1/1, and then I can't, I guess I'd have to hit a 1-drop, but whatever, I just got a swamp off the top of my library. But now I have a 1/1. Okay, Kamano faces Kakazan, and then what's the follow-up here? Nothing. All right. So obviously not a great synergy here. Kind of just want to get this guy down, I guess. So I will not attack there. I will play this and just play the sling. And then should I sacrifice something? Guess I should have just attacked with it. Look at the combo. I've already got this Dragon Spark Reactor up to 8, and I could have had them down to 17, but I didn't really think it through. What does this one give? +1/+0, so it's going to be 7 power. 8 power? Holy smokes, that's a lot. All right, I'm just going to take it because I can crack back pretty hard here. Like this. Play this thing. So now we're actually ahead on the damage race, although only by a little bit. And then I can just chump lock if they want to throw that at it. I can even just take it. Okay. Never mind. I guess that's just GG. Exile our artifacts. And they had none, and I had like 5. Wow. I had like a lot. Okay. Am I dead? I'm dead. Wow, that was a beating. We were in such a good position. We were just going to win next turn. Instead, our opponent said farewell. Okay. Anvil virus. Yeah, this all looks good to me. So we should start with the reactor. Oh my God. Double reactor. We are going to go off. No white mana. I don't want to see farewell happen again. Jeez. Oh, but we don't have the red. Close, though. I thought we might get to play the sling here, too, but we do not. Okay. Now, okay. Well, let's just play. Think I just want to play two things. Yeah, I'm just going to do that. I'd like to get the anvil down. But if I play the sling and the beetle, I can double block the centipede here, and I'm still just stacking up counters on the reactors. I also could see what they do and like try to maybe ninja something in or whatever. Ancestral Katana. Do they even have a thing? No. They're just gonna have to pay. Just pay full price. All right. Curious to see if they jam, because I'll double block. If they only attack with the Kami of Terrible Secrets, I think I'll just take it actually. Because I do want something to throw to the anvil. So I'll just take that. Okay, land's good. So I'll play this. Trigger those. Sack that. Drain you. Make a guy. Get two more triggers. Play one of these. Get two more triggers. Think this is what they call doing it? My opponent is almost up to farewell mana, though. I'm traumatized from the last game. At least if they played it now, it would kill two of their things. All right, this is a plus one counter thing. Yeah, that's fine. Let's just trade off here. Go down to seven. But now I can just start popping these. Drano. Get some more of this stuff. And I guess I'll just pass here because I want to kill the one that has the katana on it. And if I kill this now, yeah, I can play around a couple of like, I don't know, protect it from something, save it, but then they can just throw it onto here and hit me for a lot more. I think it's worth it to just pretend. All right, so let's fire this off and see how it goes. All right, you take 8. That went pretty well. Okay. They shut off one of my reactors because they had to. All right, synthesizer. Sure. Play it. Hit an island, that'll be fine. Guess I don't think I have a way to get this reactor back, so I'll just feed it to the anvil here. And this gives me 4 power to block if I'd like, which I think I will. I mean, I could take it, but if I get blown out by something that I don't see coming for the last 3, I'm going to be pretty bummed. And I also get a lifelink boost here if this works, where, yeah, they get to kill my decent ambusher, but I take out their guy and I go to a pretty safe 10, and I've got some action. Like, I can pop the synthesizer here. Let's see, I can get back something. 3 mana. Oh, can I get back a reactor? Yeah, so I could get that going perhaps. But let's pop this, because I might hit something that I might want to play with it. I did, sort of. And then I'll play this guy. And then I will cycle through one of these. No attacks. I already did this for the turn, didn't I? Oops. I guess I get the drain, but I just don't get the extra 1/1 because it only happens once per turn. Well, that just means that I could have waited and chump locked and then done it. Okay, 6/5. Yeah, you know what? I got an engine rolling here. I'm fine. And this thing has vigilance, so it's not like I'm going to be able to attack through. I can get a little something going with a scrap welder, but it's not like amazing. Like, get back a Dragonspark reactor, but it costs me a creature. And then I don't have anything going on to like feed the reactor right away outside of the anvil, kind of slowly chugging away. If this thing was attacking and it was tapped, I might consider just taking it or chump locking or something, because I can crack back and then maybe just try to get him with the anvil. But vigilance means that that's not the way that it's going to go. So I'm just going to take care of that thing. Oh, that's sweet. All right, let's jam. Play this guy. And then do this little thing. Is this sacrifice another? No, I can actually get the last one with just the anvil itself. That's pretty cool. Yeah, I mean, I'm about to combo off. I was going to play this and pay the copy and get 2 of them as well. Oh boy, this deck is sweet. Even in the game that we got blown out by Farewell, this deck was going. I mean, it was doing stuff. Okay, here's our mana. Mana creeping up. I'm mulliganing that one. This one looks fine, though. I may even keep the specialist in hand. I guess I could see getting rid of it. It's a 5-drop, so we probably can hit blue by then. But don't I just kind of need all of these other things? Probably. I mean, I could see the apprentice. This, in certain matchups, this is going to give us a way better chance to win, because by the time we get to being able to cast this, we're like, there we go, like not unlikely to have blue mana anyway. And it's so powerful. And we get to kick things off with reactor, so that's sweet. Oh my god, you had spell pierce? Wow. Did not expect that. Wow, spell pierce, huh? Okay. Okay. Spell pierce in your wind-scarred crag deck. This could be a bit of an adventure. I'm just going to pass and use Assassin's Ink here. I want to kill the silencer anyway. And because then I can play this and then this, which is the order that I actually want to play them in. Because if I go 5 mana, play this, and then 6 mana, if I draw one, play a land, play this, copy it, it's like devastating. That's really annoying. So I'm just going to ditch the swamp here. And I'm just going to Assassin's Ink the silencer. And then hope to get a land here. Okay, not quite. This isn't a bad draw, though. Hey, Samurai, don't care. Okay, there's a land. Now I can play this, and I'll go ahead and attack here as well. And they really need an answer for the specialist, unless, of course, I get... especially if I get a land here. Or wait, this thing... Oh, this thing's cheaper because of this, so I don't actually need the land. If everything stays the same... then I think I'm in pretty good shape. But if they kill this, this, or take this thing out of my hand, all right, they didn't do any of those things. So even though they played a really good card, we've got some really powerful interactions coming here. So no blocks here. And then make sure that I have one in a blue. And I do. Auto pay that. And sure, get in for one. And I guess I may as well just play my land here. Okay, and they get Scry and get a couple cards, which is admittedly really annoying. What's really annoying is that we have a stupid Dragon Spark reactor in the graveyard. But the top of our deck, oh man. Doesn't matter. They don't really have a great attack here, yeah. I'll just pass here. Okay, so they do get a huge flyer, which is a problem. But we just don't need much. You know, a couple of artifacts, and we could be really going. Are they going to use 2 removal spells in my specialist? They probably should have. So now they get in for 4. We just need a... top deck a couple of artifacts in a row, basically spells. I mean, like all of our spells are good at this point outside of like a couple of one drops, and it's about it. Because our stuff is either removal spells or artifacts. That works. So I can make two of these, although. Yeah, you know what? This actually does do something. So this thing can't block. Auto pay. This thing can't block. Attack. And if they want to trade the chef and the beetle off for my token, fine by me. Because we're going to start slamming with these four fours as well. If they don't, like, if they draw a card for the turn and play anything, then this thing can start going. Yeah, all right. So we clear these away, and then now we gain a little bit of life, and then these four ones can start to actually attack, you know, depending on what they do here. This becomes annoying because it's the 1/3 that dies, and, you know, it trades off for one of these and draws them a card. But for now, they're in a bit of a pickle. Like, they can slam us for five, which is pretty good. But then if they go like land spell, then, you know, they're in much worse shape. We got this is good. Like, drawing the Unstoppable Ogre, nice. We just need like a couple more draws like that where we just hit a, you know, medium artifact in our deck and we'll be okay. But if we don't, like, if we go land here, we're probably dead. Like, they're pressuring us and have five cards in hand, and like it's not getting better. Moth Rider Patrol. Okay, but now this is a 4/4, so I guess they're not planning on attacking us. But these Unstoppable Ogres are gonna crunch. Like, they're pretty good. Oh, you are attacking me. Okay, well. Spewing one damage, they're not great. All right, there's a land. Speaking of not great, yeah, fine. I have to keep this thing up to chump. Thirst for knowledge, sure. I'll probably just take this. Yeah, we just needed to find another spell here. I mean, now we're kind of dead. Let's see if they block. Right, they did. Well, this keeps us alive in the sense that they're not going to kill us this turn. So I'm live to maybe removal for this or running artifacts or something like that. I used ink on that two drop. Yeah, we'll see. This gives them just about lethal. All right, that has to be one of our better draws. So I want this one to go first because I want to see what we hit off of the synthesizer. And I am going to copy it because obviously, all right. That is not what I wanted to see here. And we hit the anvil and now don't have the mana for it. Cool. Not that it necessarily matters, but. So, yeah, we're just dead. Man. So close. Just one too many lands. Just that one spell pierce. Like, you know, just. Ugh, so close. All right, is this a keeper? Sure. Sling or Ronin? Sling, I guess. I'll just curve out. See what we draw here. I think I'm going to go for Synthesizer here to try to hit a land. Because if it's not a land, ooh, it's the land. Not bad. Although, not perfect. But still, not bad. I don't want to, I don't want to draw non-lands anyway, you know? So I'd prefer that. So should I move this over? Is there a reason to do that? Probably better just if they play like a 1/3, I don't know. It's pretty much risk-free, I guess. Drawing a mountain here would be pretty good. Prodigy's Prototype, sure. Let's play Scrap Welder. This is a 1/2, crew 2. Koi. All right. You're going to get in. Fair enough. Not hitting lands here is pretty annoying. But attacking for 6 is pretty good. They're going to chump. Okay. I will get down a flyer. And that way, if they want to crew here, then they kind of get punished for it. I mean, they could very easily just play a creature first, but no, they're not going to. Land drop, please. I can play 2 spells next turn, most likely, if I hit a land. Inky and a Brute Suit. And this is a crew 1. And they can crew it with either of these. Mm-hmm. There's a land. Can actually play, I think. Oh, not quite. I almost can get down everything here, but not quite. All right, so this can get in, and so can this and this, because if it trades off for the Brute Suit, then fine. I'll live with it. I could also consider playing the Chain Flail Centipede and then just equipping it to the Mechanaut. It's a little bit all in, but it's pretty. It does let me swing for 4 in the air. Which isn't bad. But I also could like play the other Mechanaut and then play this or this. Yeah, that's probably better. All right, so let's just jam here. And then they'll probably just fire up the Brute Suit and trade for the Scrap Welder, which is fine. And if they trade for the Construct, then the Sling falls off, and then they also take an extra damage. Which one's it going to be? The Welder, all right. I'll allow it. And they're down to 5, and so I can play this and this and this. Not bad. Not too bad. This could also be a surprise. Like an extra couple of damage that maybe they're not anticipating. All right, they just gave up because I flooded the board. Whew, that was sweet. Just barely hit our mana requirements there. That was actually not color as much as amount. We just missed a couple of land drops after three, which wasn't disaster, but it's like when your opponent has five mana and you have three and you can only play like one red card a turn, it starts to make you go, uh-oh. But we just got over. All right, so we have two blue cards, but we also have Virus Beetle and Reactor in hand. I don't know if this is a mulligan. It's probably close. Because if we never hit blue, we're probably just going to lose. Yeah, I think it's a keeper. I think it's close. Like, we're on the draw. We've got a few turns to hit, and we can do some things before we do that are, you know, decent at keeping us alive and whatever, just for another turn or two. Because if we hit this thing, then these cards are great. Fang? Oh, boy, oh, boy. But I think I am supposed to play the Reactor first. If I play the Mechanaut now, then I can go Beetle plus Reactor next turn. But if I play the Reactor now, I can go Beetle plus Mechanaut next turn. You know what? I think if I can get in for the just the hit for two with this Mechanaut, it's probably outpaces having one additional counter on the Reactor. I refuse to block. Ooh, and I can make that extra cheap as well. Yeah, let's go Reactor. And then I'll play this. Because that triggers the Reactor as well, but and it's a little more mana efficient, and it gives us another flyer as well. So let's do that. Jamming on you. And they're going to fade that. Okay, so that's pretty cool. I mean, it was only a two mana spell, and it ate, you know, something pretty important there. I'd love the synthesizer, but I think it's better just to get Mechanaut going. So I'm just going to jam. Play Mechanaut and play Beetle. And then I'll just play a land. Because now I have a nice little Air Force going here. Five power in the air is pretty good. And I have Assassin's Ink to kill a potential blocker. I don't think I care about that, really. All right, Reactor. I get to five you here. And then I guess I can chump block if I have to. I don't have to yet though. The Assassin's Ink can still do work. I'm just not as worried about taking four a turn or maybe chump block every once in a while on this thing. As if they play like a flyer or something like that, creature with reach or something. They're getting back the forest from their hand. Wow. All right. They must have something sweet for next turn. Okay. So let's play this. Sure, it doesn't matter. And we hit another Montaigne. And I can go attack, attack, attack. You're down to six, and then I can play this. And this thing's for three. So this thing is just about ready to pop off and kill them. I'm just going to take this again. Because now if they target the Reactor, I can just pop it and kill their Fang. Spinning wheel kick on that guy. All right, well, I got really bad news. GG. as we say in the business. Yeah, spinning wheel kick has a high upside, but dear God. I mean, that was just the entire game. Okay, I have to mulligan this one. One color is definitely not going to do it. We also have a double black here, so we'll get rid of that. One lander, no. And we'll keep this. Get rid of this and a mountain. Pretty bad. Pretty bad. I mean, we get to do some Dragon Spark reactor things, but I don't know. It's hard to feel too confident about this one. Sure. People just kill these now, which is probably smart. I'm certainly here for it. So, Chain Flail Centipede. Will this block this? Sure. Is this crew 100? Pretty much. So this one actually can't do the thing? Huh. So it's like a pilot, but not. Kind of interesting. I think I'm going to go with Virus Beetle and get a little greedy here. If I can sneak this Virus Beetle through and ninjutsu this, I might be able to get a little extra value. Like if they don't have a creature here, damn. Two. Oh, but these are both crew three. So they actually have to trade off and they're tapped out. Yeah, I'll trade anyway. Oh, sweet. So I don't get to replay it right now, but I mean, unless they can dump their hand, I get to Virus Beetle them for a card. I mean, they know about it, so like if they drew a land, they may just sandbag it, but it's getting something either way. So that's pretty sweet. And is this one that copies or recrews or whatever? Oh, that's actually annoying. So they get to just crew both of these now? I'd like a swamp, please. That is not a swamp. Okay, well, I'll get the last card out of your hand. Ooh, it was a good one too. And I will attack with this. And just try to keep my life total up. I'll chump block the 6/6. Oh, they found a card off the top that crews either way. But yeah, I'm still going to chump the 6/6 here. It's just too much damage to give up. But I get to crack back again for 3 lifelink. It's helping me at least a bit. Okay, so crunch. And then I guess I just play this. And then I can go double Unstoppable Ogre or Assassin's Ink, assuming that I'm vaguely alive here. Because this actually can block something now, like this. It can actually block this. So I probably take 6 here. So no blocks. Okay. What do you got? Nothing. Sweet. All right. So is it more important to use Assassin's Ink to kill something here or... No, I don't think it is. I think I'm supposed to just play Ogre and then copy it. This thing can't attack, I guess. I this thing, sure, but they can just crew, or yeah, they can still just crew though. And just get this 3-4 flyer up so they can eat the ambusher. So I'll just pass. And then I have Assassin's Inc. for something big. I can double block the Sentinel with these two doofuses. Oh man. And they get to kill my flyer here. Damn. That's a good top deck. Yeah, that leaves me pretty dead here. I'm going to have to suicide this thing in. 4-8. I actually can attack for 11. Wait, can I just win right here? Did they just throw this whole thing away? Thank you? Wow. Okay. Wow, wow, wow. That was not the way to go for the opponent there. They got really lucky and ripped that Saga removal spell and then just left themselves dead to any removal. Maybe they thought they could still crew up the 6-6 again or something and like they had a backup plan, but just like dying to any removal spell there just doesn't seem... Like, you don't want to take that risk when you're that far ahead, right? Wow. All right. I'll take it, though. I know I've done that before, so. Okay. That was a mold of 5. Yeah, I'll take that for sure. All right. This looks good. We get to Oni Cult Anvil, and then just, like, we actually get to do some stuff here. This is pretty sweet. Although, people keep killing my artifact. So if they do that, then it's like less cool, but. All right. I accept. Okay. So I guess I play this centipede. No, I play this guy. Because what I want to do is next turn play an artifact and then sacrifice it and then start making treasures that I can sack to this. Kind of indefinitely. That's a crew 2, right? Okay. I guess the sling's better to sack. Because this gives me the ability to cast this or this coming up. The question is, do I want to play the centipede right now? This would cut me off from top decking a land or just using the anvil to get this down next turn. So yeah, I think given that I'm not under such immense pressure, it's probably better to wait. I mean, I'm going to get hit by the prototype, which is, it can get out of hand. But man, my hand is so sick if I can play this specialist. Next turn. Oh, interesting. But they tapped this. Oh, they still have 2, though. Okay. Okay, another anvil. But I think I really want to try to get the specialist down this turn. So I think what I can do is sack this for blue. That'll make me a 1-1. Then sacrifice the 1-1, which kills a creature. And then I can do this to make another treasure. So I think that all works. I've never actually done that before quite, but. And then make a treasure and then play this thing. So the big question is, does this specialist stay on the battlefield here? Because if it does, I can do some pretty powerful stuff. I mean, look at my hand, right? It just kind of goes insane. But if it doesn't, I'm pretty behind here. Like if they just, I don't know, use something to kill it. Like if they don't kill it, then I might be able to still win. Meaning like if they arrest it or completion it or whatever. That if they don't, like I'm doing things. All right, so they didn't. Which means they actually don't have a great attack here because even the prototype just gets double blocked and trades for a 1-1. Wow, am I not getting attacked at all here? This is great. Yeah, they're reading the specialist like, uh-oh. Lands would be really good for me though, just so I can dump stuff on the battlefield here. Because right now I don't have blue mana for the to pay for the copy. So I have to like sacrifice this, do this thing, and then do all the copying stuff. So it's kind of annoying. So I will do that. The question is, do I want two Dragon Spark reactors? Or do I want two Oni Cult Anvils? The draining only happens like per anvil, but I do get to make a whole bunch of 1/1s, which is like kind of cool. If I do the reactor, I get to just pile up a bunch of counters on it, but like it's not really doing what I need it to do right now. Like four mana to activate, it's really expensive and kind of time consuming. I really just want to start copying creatures, but I'm just short on mana, so I can't. All right, well, I'll just go for another anvil here. This is cool because it ETBs first, so then I'll get the 1/1 as well. And then I can churn through these. So this one already made a 1/1. Oh yeah, it grayed it out. That's kind of cool. So now I have three anvils. So that's draining for three a turn. It adds up pretty quick. Okay, but that's still not a way to kill my specialist. Ooh, shoot. I wonder if they have the... I don't really feel like I have a choice here, but they could easily have one in a white deal two. Or deal four, I mean. But I am just a bit too far behind here, I think, to get cute. And they didn't have it anyway. Okay, so that doesn't do anything there. Yeah, this mana situation's really getting awkward. Because I just need one more to be able to copy these three drops. But this isn't bad. Because I can just throw these things around as well. Also, if I'm not going to have enough mana to actually sacrifice these for effect, I can just sacrifice them to the anvil and keep the 1/1s on board, I guess. That being said, it's going to get completely insane here. Like, if this goes unchecked for another couple of turns, like, just sacrificing anything, like, if I just tap one of these and sacrifice a 1/1, it drains them for 3, and it adds 3 counters to each of these. So it gets pretty stupid. All right, well. I don't know what they have. I guess I'll block like that. Because I'm not actually taking that much damage here. And I need to just have one thing to sack to the anvil. So, all right. They just threw that guy away. I'm in for that. All right, we hit a land as well. Okay, so land drop. Should I kill this? I could just Twisted Embrace and kill it here. Just in case they go off. I wonder if that's what I'm supposed to do. It's kind of boring. I can put it on one of my artifacts, but no, I'll just put it here. Kill that. Take 7, but I can serve up for a bunch here. Yeah, you know what? Taste it. Look at this. 2 more. 2 more. Yeah, that's just crazy. And then I can drain for a couple of more too, but I don't think I need to just yet. Cover unit, return target. Okay, but it doesn't have haste, so it's like just gonna sit there for now. And I assume they're just going to jam. Although if they do, they're like probably dead on the crackback. Yeah, I'm just going to take it. I think they're just dead. I think they're just super, super dead, actually. I have a card, though. It's Guardians. Yeah, that's not even close to enough. So I crack this to itself. Kill that. Kill them. Easy. Wow. That was off of 4 lands for like, or 3 lands forever. And the Treasure Maker guy was like super clutch. Man, this deck has the capability of doing like really dumb stuff. That was sick. That was just stupid. Wow. All right. Okay, this Construct Centipede. Yeah, this is fine. I can just bash him once with the Ronin, and then this is a combo. Or I could play the Apprentice. Yeah, I'll just do that. Looks like they're going to 2-1 guy me here. Oh, it's Prosperous Thief. 3-2. Okay, fair. That's tough. That means I probably just need to play this Construct because like this thing's going to get out of hand. Oh, wow. They're going to play the Disruptor now? That is not normal. Yeah, I'll attack here. So normally I'd want to get the Dragon Spark reactor down, but this thing's such a pain. Oh yeah, and then this thing can just hit too. So yeah, that makes sense actually. But we're in big trouble. Like, cause they could just dump their entire hand with this start that they've had. And we need a little time to get the reactor going, and we don't have any removal besides it. So this could be it for us for sure. Okay, they still only get the one treasure, but it is four more damage coming through. Yeah, that ain't it. Play the reactor. And I'm not going to attack here. But we are screwed. Yeah, this is really bad. What a good start. Oh, it's an interesting choice, though. Because it lets us block here, and it means that they don't actually get to hit us to get a treasure token this turn. So maybe they just don't need it. Okay, definitely don't care about that. I'm just going to ditch this thing. Yeah. I think I'm just supposed to cycle this to try to hit a land. Because if I can get this thing up to two, then I can take out the flyer and it does something at least. But yeah, I think we're just dead here. Just a great start. The turn one Network Disruptor into turn two Prosperous Thief Network Disruptor is really tough. Like, they just have the ability to make a bunch of treasures and apply pressure to our life total and stuff that's just really difficult to deal with. Okay, I think I'm supposed to attack here and then ninjutsu this because that puts me up to 9, which makes it pretty hard for my opponent to just outright kill me there. And then I can play this or this and this. And I think I'll go for the two cards here instead. Because what they wanted to do was use the ninja's kunai to kill me. And this kind of takes that plan away. Like, they're probably going to have to throw it at the ambusher next turn. Something like that. I mean, if they don't have anything, like if they use this or if it's not available, I could even go centipede reconfigure onto the amateur and just get a huge lifelink hit in to try to buy me a bunch of time. But like I said, realistically, they probably need to use. Okay. Everything's coming in. Okay, so they're going to hit me for 9 here. Oh, this is 9. That's lethal. All right. Fair enough. Yeah, I like my line. I think that was the right way to play it. Because I couldn't have gotten the monkey on there. to gain one extra life. So we'll have to settle for a 5-3 with this one. A little bit inconsistent. Really great draw for my opponent there. Very difficult to beat. I actually, you know, if we don't die that turn, there's a chance. Like, we get to do another huge lifelink hit, and it becomes kind of difficult for us to get raced at that point. But yeah, just not quite enough. Still, 5 wins with this deck's okay as we figure it out, and the potentially kind of rough mana as well. I want to remind you, this video is brought to you by Channel Fireball. Make sure you check them out for all your magic needs. And if you want to find me on social media, it's Marshall_LR pretty much everywhere. You can find everything related to the podcast I do with Luis Scott Vargas every week called Limited Resources over at lrcast.com. Thanks so much for hanging out. We'll see you next time.